The U.S. is in the midst of a growing mental health crisis. Those suffering from severe mental illness die, on average, 10 to 20 years earlier than the general population. And while medical research has shown that behavioral therapy and medication are effective treatments, patients often face numerous obstacles to accessing care. These issues are particularly pertinent to veterans, who suffer in high rates from PTSD, substance abuse disorder, and other related issues. Of all government-sponsored healthcare programs, the Department of Veteran Affairs, or VA, provides the most comprehensive insurance coverage for mental health, but many veterans still report difficulty accessing care, primarily due to long wait times. This paper studies how delays in mental health treatment for veterans affects their long-term mortality. The author tracks wait times for all patients who arrived at any emergency department, or ED, across the VA system with a mental health-related condition between January 2001 and February 2015. Wait time is the time between a patient's initial ED visit and their follow-up mental health appointment, and the paper asks whether longer wait times affect a patient's future outcomes. Now, a problem is that individual wait times may be related to factors that also affect future outcomes. For example, patients who are deemed high risk may be fast-tracked and have systematically shorter wait times. To address this, instead of using a patient's own wait time, the author constructs, for each individual, a measure of clinic congestion that is unrelated to that patient's own characteristics. This is the mean wait time experienced by all other patients who arrived at the same hospital during the same 2-week period and are assigned the same type of follow-up appointment. This measure of mean wait time is strongly correlated with the patient's actual wait time, but, crucially, is uncorrelated with their risk level, as measured by predicted 2-year mortality rates. The author uses this measure of congestion to compare outcomes for patients who happened to arrive to an ED when mean wait time was particularly high, with outcomes for other patients who arrived at the same ED in the same month. Her key finding is that longer wait times increase long-term mortality rates. A 1 standard deviation increase in mean wait time, or an increase of 11.7 days, increases 2-year mortality rates by 1.5%. These effects are long-lasting, persisting for at least 5 years after the initial ED visit, and are almost entirely driven by patients with substance use disorders or psychosis. How do relatively small treatment delays affect long-term mortality? One possibility is that longer wait times are associated with supply-side factors that are detrimental for patients. For example, mental health appointment delays may be correlated with more general hospital or clinic congestion, leading to poor overall quality of care. While plausible, several pieces of evidence suggest this is not the case. Mental health wait time is not correlated with wait times for other hospital services, and is also not correlated with mortality rates for patients who arrive to the ED with non-mental health diagnoses. There is also no evidence that mental health clinic congestion leads to more rushed care for patients at their follow-up appointments, and while ED doctors do appear to compensate for longer appointment delays by being more likely to prescribe medication at the initial visit, this likely counteracts the negative effect of longer wait times as medication mitigates mortality risk. So, overall, there is little to suggest that supply-side factors can explain the mortality effect of longer wait times. Instead, the evidence points to changes in patients' behavior. Longer wait times increase the probability that patients fail to attend their follow-up appointment. A 1 standard deviation increase in mean wait time leads to a 2 percentage point reduction in the probability of attending the follow-up appointment, and patients with high mean wait time are far more likely to disengage entirely from mental health care. Notably, this does not imply disengagement from the healthcare system overall. These same patients are actually more likely to attend a primary care appointment during the follow-up period. This partly reflects the impact of deteriorating physical health, but also that those struggling to receive timely mental health treatment may turn to their primary care doctor instead. Consistent with this, veterans with high wait times are more likely to receive mental health treatment via primary care alone. To shed light on the mortality effects of this substitution, the author groups hospitals according to their level of patient disengagement from mental health care, and shows that relative to low disengagement hospitals, those with high disengagement have very large mortality effects, but only when disengagement is defined vis-a-vis specialty mental health care. When looking at disengagement from all forms of mental health care, including primary care, there is little to no difference in mortality effects. This indicates that mental health expertise matters, and that it is specifically disengagement from specialty mental health care that drives the mortality effects observed here. Thus, this paper shows that shorter hospital waiting times can be vital in keeping patients engaged with mental health care, and that missing a single visit can have substantial downstream effects on a patient's well-being. In this context, it is not just affordable care, but also timely care that matters. To read more on this topic, you can check out the paper's references to other related work. This includes research on mental health treatment, the effects of longer wait times in healthcare, and their use as a rationing mechanism.